The map interface, remember this map interface is the unique interface in the collection hierarchy. Why? Because it does not extends the collection interface. Now let's see the hierarchy first and then I will tell you why. So the two classes which, this was an interface, so two classes which implements this map interface is HashMap and HashTable. Now we have another interface which is sorted map. And that particular sorted map has an implementing classes, which is a tree map, something similar to a set, if you can recall or remember. So let's see the unique feature of the hash map. So hash map is nothing but a non-synchronized natured collection, and it contains only one null key, but can contain multiple null values. So why? Because keys are always unique and values may or may not be unique. It's not a necessary condition. But keys for the map should always be a unique element. Hence, only one null key, which is a unique element, is allowed, not more than that. But multiple null values can be allowed in the hash map. Now, what about hash table? Hash map was not synchronized, but hash table is a synchronized collection in nature and it does not allow any null key or null value. So this is a very important difference between hash map and hash table. It will for sure be asked in an interview, like, what is the difference? Then you have to tell that the two main differences that this is not synchronized, this is synchronized, and it does allow one null key, multiple null values, but it does not allow neither the null keys nor the null values. Now, like, moving ahead to sorted map, all the entries are maintained in the ascending order here. So this is how the sorted are always, right? It is always sorted. So it's the ascending order in which the objects are maintained. So the best way to do that is to implicitly implement the red-black tree implementation for the sorting purpose. And it cannot store any null keys, just as the hash table. So that was all about the map interfaces and the collection complete hierarchy. You should remember each and every unique thing I've told you in this particular question. Now let's move ahead to the another question. The very important question they ask you just after the collection thing is, most probably, is that why map does not extend the collection interface. So this is a very important question. You need to understand that map interface is actually having a key value pair structure, whereas all the collection interfaces is actually collection of just objects which are stored in a structured manner with a specific access mechanism. And the main reason as to why map does not extend this is that there are basically, how do you add elements in a collection? So if you add an element in a collection, you always use add method, where you pass an object and that particular e object will be added to the collection interface. But the collection interface, which is map, does not support just one array, one element, but also supports the key value pair. So it's like put k comma v, which is key and v both, key and value both. Hence, it cannot extend the collection interface. So it's basic, but still it is an integral part of Java collection framework because it's the only collection which can have a key value pair in it. So it's a very unique but a very important integral part of Java collection framework. Now I'll give you an example. This is something which is documentation of these two classes. So suppose I have one list for you. So this is the implementation of list interface. It actually extends the collection interface, but this map does not extend any of the collection interface, but still it's a very integral part of collection interface.